Someone's got to stall. Come on, big man, run. Come on, throw the ball. You're playing the greatest game of all.
Hello there and welcome to the greatest game of all. In this program I'm going to look back over the 79 season, talk to some of the greats of the past, have a look at some of the exciting incidents, hear from rugby league wives and, you know, one would think a side capable of winning a competition one year could with almost identical personnel win or go close the next year. Balmain won in 1969, faded to 6th in 1970. St George defeated Parramatta in the grand final replay in 77 and finished 7th in 78. And this year, Manly finished 7th after whacking Cronulla 16-0 in last year's grand final. I've got Frank Stanton with me to attempt to explain this paradox. An out-of-work coach.
Yeah.
How does that grab it?
Oh, it's a great feeling, Rex. A lot of
a relief?
Yes, great relief.
What went wrong this year, Frank?
Well, it's difficult to assess or put it down to one point. It's a combination of many things in my mind. There was the obvious letdown for some of the players after the Kangaroo Tour, in which we had seven players involved.
So did St George in 1959. They won it in 1960.
Yes, but those seven players didn't have the sorts of injuries that these guys endured during the year. On top of that, our main defensive player, Terry Randall, we only had the benefit of his presence for 80 minutes in the whole series, one full game of 80 minutes. There were worrying injuries to other players at various times, and to be quite blunt, there was a number of players who failed to find form all through the year.
What are your personal reasons for retiring after all this time? Have you had enough, or do you just need a break?
Yes, I feel that I need a break, and I was beginning not to enjoy the situation, and I think once you do that, you're not doing your job effectively.
Well, this grand final that we're watching last year was a great thing for you personally. You were the Australian, New South Wales, City coach, Kangaroo coach. But that run of five wins on the trot for Manly last year must have made you very proud. They played six games in 24 days.
Yes, it was. I felt at the time that it was the beginning of some sort of tradition that might endure at Manly, and unfortunately, this season was sort of tended to take the gloss off that, but it was a magnificent effort at the time, and only I and the players appreciate just what some of them did go through to do that.
Could you have had the job again this year if you'd wanted it?
Oh, I think that's a matter for the committee, Rex. It was never ever discussed. It was decided early in the year that I wasn't going to be the coach next year.
Are the reports we've heard of personal antipathy between you and some of the Manly players, or two in specifically I'm referring to, I won't mention names, were they exaggerated or were they false?
Oh, they're not false. The antipathy extends only to the far as football is concerned. I think personally off the field that we're good friends, but it's the same in any situation. Somebody's got to be the boss and the other people have to fall in line, and that's the way it is.
What does 1980 hold for Frank Stanton?
A bit of golf, tennis, squash.
And that's it?
Yes, that's
1981?
It. 1981? We'll see what happens then.
Likely Manly again?
Oh, I don't know, Rex.
You don't look that far ahead.
No.
Well, of the 12 first grade coaches for 79, only six, Bath, Masters, Glossop, Fulton, Stacker and Ryan, have definitely stated that they'll stay for 1980. So you can see rugby league coaching is not conducive to becoming old on the job. We're going to take a pause and return with a rugby league fullback superstar of the past who'll rate the current crop of custodians.
The greatest